Hi, I'm Lisa Elliott, SDSU Commodity Marketing Specialist. Today, I will be discussing new generation agricultural marketing contracts. The emergence of complex grain marketing contracts, both over-the-counter products, such as accumulator contracts, and combinations of futures and vanilla options, such as price plus contracts, has complicated the management of farm portfolio risk. These new, complex grain marketing contracts are often given unique names and are unique in the way they manage risk. They typically are grouped together and described as new generation marketing contracts. We will compare a few of the attributes of the new generation contracts offered by firms including CHS, ADM, and Cargill. We also discuss potential option strategies that could accomplish similar risk management. It is critical to understand all details of an elevator contract, as subtle differences may exist between firms, even though the contracts may seem similar. Specific new generation marketing contracts we discuss here include seasonal averaging contracts, premium contracts, minimum price contracts, and accumulator contracts. Averaging contracts are typically just an average of daily futures closes over a given time period to determine a contract price. There are also averaging contracts that include downside price protection. These contracts are similar to buying a put and then selling a set amount of bushels each day, usually an equal amount. Premium contracts typically provide a premium to the futures price that is being offered today. If in the future, the producer is willing to sell more bushels if the futures price is higher. Premium contracts usually only commit a set amount of bushels in the future sale, and if the price on a future date is below a target price, then a sale of additional bushels is not required. Premium contracts are similar to selling a call and selling a futures contract. Minimum price contracts typically lock in a basis and floor, but allow for some upside potential. These type of contracts are similar to a basis contract to lock in a basis, plus buying a put to ensure a minimum futures price. Another type of minimum price contract exists with limited upside potential, but usually a higher minimum price. This would be similar to a basis contract plus buying a put and selling a call, or what is typically called a caller. Finally, accumulator contracts offer premiums on a non-guaranteed amount of bushels. In accumulator contracts, the bushels are committed and sold at a premium rate if the market does not fall below a threshold called a knockout barrier. Accumulator contracts also require a greater rate of bushels to be sold if the prices rise above what is called the strike price. The amount of bushels sold in an accumulator contract depends on the number of days the futures price remains above the knockout barrier and above or below the strike price. Accumulator contracts would be similar to buying an in-the-money vanilla put and selling out-of-the-money vanilla calls. However, accumulator contracts are different in that the amount of bushels sold is dependent on the time and price path of the futures contract during the duration of the contract period. This difference typically allows higher premiums to be achieved, but may involve less risk reduction. There are positives and negatives of producers using elevator contracts versus performing the trades themselves. The positives are producers can be provided an upfront payment for an agreed sell to the firm. Moreover, a producer would not have to maintain maintenance and margin in a futures options trading account. Further, elevators can sometimes provide producers with unique risk management opportunities that would only be available by firms that offer over-the-counter products. Finally, contracting with elevators can give producers the opportunity to lock in bases. The negatives of utilizing contracts through elevators would be that they often result in committing your commodity delivery to a specific firm. Thus, opportunities to deliver to different locations that may offer better basis pricing at a future date are lost. Also, an elevator may charge a greater fee on the contract than what you would have to pay in a trading fees on your own. Finally, by contracting with an elevator, a producer exposes themselves to the specific financial risk of that firm, such as default risks. Thus, it is important to know the financial health of an elevator you are considering contracting bushels to account for potential counterparty risk. Trading on your own will typically require a producer to have a line of credit to manage maintenance and margin calls. However, interest costs may be less than having an elevator perform the trades where a set fee is included. Trading on your own may also give a producer greater flexibility when to execute trades and the type of risk management strategies a producer wants to utilize. Finally, when a producer performs their own trades or trades through a brokerage service, they do not limit their ability to deliver to any elevator in the future, depending upon pricing and other potential benefits. For more information on this topic, visit igrow.org.